So hello students, last class we discussed about the components of motherboard, and also we discussed basically we started with what is a computers and also the different evolution of computers, the normal introduction to computers. There we studied different units of computers, how computer works as a single unit which is made up of different individual units like input unit, central processing, and also we discussed about the memory unit or storage unit and also the output unit. So CPUs are already we have discussed, that is the central processing unit. I think this is all which you are familiar already. That's what we discussed in the last class. And also we discussed about the major components, and also we talk about the limitation of computers, how they are efficient and why do we use computers, why the computers are popular. So these are all things also we discussed along with the major components, that is how computer can able to assist humans. So they are not like humans, but still they can perform all the operation that human can do. So therefore what we do, in order to do these operations, so we have some components, assisted by some components. They are hardware, the software, data, and also the users. And also we discussed about all these components. And then we studied about a typical organization, the block diagram of computers, the organization of computers, where we have an input, then we have discussed about the central processing unit, internal consisting of control unit, arithmetic logical unit, and also registers. And then we have talked about memory unit. There are two types, the primary memory, secondary memory, and also one more we discussed is the output units. There are different types of output. Depending on requirements, we may use different types of output. So then we discussed the major hardware components. What are the components inside the computers? How computer, this chapter, so we are going to learn all the components. All external, we discussed about different types of input devices in the last academic, and also output devices. But now in this class, we are trying to learn about the what are the inside components, like memory, the devices, memory components, and also the main memory, second memory, the processor, the main processor, and how the processor, how do you identify processor, and what is the speed of the processor, something like all internal components we are going to discuss, how all these components are connected. So that's what we are discussing here. There we started with the main component of the computers. In terms of hardware, if you look at the computers as a hardware, there the vital role, the main role is played by the motherboard. It's also known as a system board. So which connects all major components of the computers. It's already I've discussed in the last class. And what are the major components? We'll discuss one by one. And the motherboards are classified or characterized by three factors. Depending on three factors, what are three factors means? One is a form factor, the second one is the chipset, and also we have a processor socket. Then I give an introduction to the types of motherboard. So there we have different types of motherboard. We learn one by one. The first one is XT motherboard, and then we have AT motherboard, BB80 motherboard, and one more is ATX motherboard. So we learn one by one. So the motherboards are classified, it's like evolution of motherboard. So earlier we have older processor, and also we have a motherboard which supports for limited features. We have a limited, all are limited. Now we have advanced. So we have many features which is advanced, depending on requirements. We may use earlier, it is not support for USB. It is not supporting for graphics. Today we support for USB graphics. And also we can see the monitors, type of monitors which you are going to connect, high definitions. Earlier we do not have LCD monitor or CRT monitors. That's a different technology, but today is like that. How computers gone through the evolution, similarly the hardware, the motherboard is also has gone through evolution. So there we have a different types of mother, like starting with the Pentium 1. Today we have i3, i7 processor. So there, depending on this processor, we have a different types of motherboard. We start with the first motherboard, that is called XT. XT means extended technology motherboard. So normally motherboards are identified by the processor socket, what type of slots or sockets are available in the motherboard. And then the second one is the slots, the RAM, main memory slot, what type of slot, we'll discuss all difference. And one more is the expansion slots, what type of expansion slot it is supporting. And one more is the pin connectors, what type of, whether it's a 12 pin, 24 pin or 20 pins, we'll discuss all those things. The main characteristics to identify the different types of motherboards, the processor socket is the one, the second one is the RAM slot, and third one is the expansion slots, and last one is the pin connector. That's how many pins is there in the power connectors. Let us learn one by one and you'll be able to understand. So first one is extended technology. The XT stands for extended technology. These are the oldest motherboard. In this motherboard, we can find the LIF, low insertion force socket. That's a motherboard. On that socket, we can place the processor. So LIF, low insertion force sockets. And also it supports for RAM slots. So what is the RAM here? It means dual inline memory modules, called as a DIMM, D-I-M-M. So dual inline memory module. And the expansion slot it is supported is ISA, Industrial Standard Architecture. And then we have a 12-pin power connectors. So this is what we called as a XT motherboard. So features of XT motherboard, it supports these features. So whatever the processor it is used means, earlier Pentium 1, Pentium MMX, we call multimedia extended technology, Pentium 2 processors are used with this type of motherboard. So if you have a Pentium 2, Pentium 1, or Pentium MMX processor, then this XT motherboard is used earlier. That's why it has an expansion slot, it cannot be expanded. So it has a standard architecture. Only for the, like what we industrial standard architecture, so only for that purpose you can use. But now you cannot use for other, upgrading is quite difficult. But only these processors, these motherboard can work efficiently. Then we have a 80 motherboard. So later on they produced one more motherboard, that is like Pentium 1, we jumped to Pentium 2, Pentium 3. So in Pentium 3 processor, we started with this motherboard. So what is this 80 stands for means advanced technology. So it's advanced technology motherboard, have a PGA, that is a pin grid array, and sockets for the main processor. And then we have SDRAM, synchronous dynamic RAM slots, and 20 pin power connectors, and the expansion slot is PCI as well as ISA slots. What is PCI means? Peripheral component interconnect. That indicates its support for expansion. You can add a new additional card to it. And so the what are the processor used in this with the 80 motherboard is the Pentium 3 processor. So with the Pentium 3 processor, we can use the PCI. That indicates they can be extended. It's not only for industrial architecture only. It's not for standards. It can be used for multipurpose as well. But the ISA means it means for particular applications. That's why it is industrial standard architecture. We have a set of standards. Only for those purposes the computer can be used. But when you take PCI means it support, that's expansion. You can add additional card. Card means a memory. It's not memory, it's a circuit, integrated circuit where you can mount. As a result, it can support for a new devices. So that is what PCI, peripheral component interconnect. And this are used with the Pentium 3 processor. So next we have a baby 80 motherboard. So it's like, it's advanced, we try to improve the 80 motherboards. What they did means in this, they combine both. It's a combination of XT and 80. They have a slot type that is a PGA, what we call pin grid array processor sockets, and supports for both SDRAM and DDR RAM. So this is a new one, so double data rate RAM. And then it also supports for a PCI and also ISAs. And it supports for 12-pin power connectors and also 20-pin power connectors. And also it supports for ports, that's very important. So earlier they are not supporting this support for the port. So the processor with the Pentium 3 and Pentium 4s are used with the baby 80 motherboard. So today we have a more sophisticated motherboard, that is what we call as the ATX motherboard. ATX stands for Advanced Technology Extended. It's the latest of all motherboards. So this is designed by ATX factors, form factors. In this motherboard, we can see MPGA, multi-pin grid array processor sockets, DDRAM slots, double data rate slots, and also it supports for one more new, that's the AGP slots, accelerated graphic ports. So because of this AGP slots, so the computers are used for entertainment purpose to create like animations, graphic effects, and also to like 3D effects in the graphics. That's an additional slot. So that can be found only in the ATX motherboards. So this AGP is not found in the other type of motherboards. And also it comes with the primary and secondary IDE interfaces. IDE means integrated digital electronics. That's like secondary memory and primary may be connected through this cables. So we'll discuss all the, this IDE connectors. And also we have a serial advanced technology extend attachment connectors. And it supports for both 20-pin and 24-pin ATX power connector and supports for ports. So that is the latest motherboard available. So whenever you go to the market, if you ask now, we want motherboard means we have to buy ATX motherboard, because that is the latest motherboard available. It supports for, like I said, it's a multi-pin grid array, which is can be used with the i3, i5, i7 processor along with the P4 processor as well. So if you have an ATX motherboard, means you can upgrade your computers. Your processor can be changed from Pentium 3 or Core processor to i3, i5, i7 processor if it supports for that's an ATX motherboard. If you have MPGA, that's a multi-pin grid array. And also it contains DDRAM slots, double data RAM slots, and also PCA, and also it supports for AGP slots, and also the primary and secondary. And it has a 24-pin power cables. So this is the different types of motherboard. So in exams, they may be asking any one type of motherboard. So all expansions are important, so try to learn all expansions, and also learn about the, it's like study like evolution. So based on background, so we need a socket type, and then we need the slots, different types of slots, RAM slot and expansion slot, and type of power connector, the pins. So, and also whether they support for port or not. So based on this, we have different types of motherboard. So we have first is XT motherboard, then we have a AT motherboard, then we have a baby AT motherboard, and finally we have a ATX motherboard. So now let us learn the more about the different components of motherboard. So when you talk about components of motherboard, means everything what you see in the computers, which is inside, outside, all the components of computers will be there in a motherboard. That's what the components of motherboard means, everything, including your keyboard, mouse, and speakers, or whatever you see on the computers, all are connected to the, all are the components of motherboard. So you can see there is the processor. Of course, whenever we talk about computers, means the processor is very important. We have a processor, and this is BIOS, I'll explain, basic input-output system. Then we have a CMOS, complementary metal oxide semiconductor battery, I'll discuss. Also, we have slots, different types of slot, and disk controllers like secondary primary memory. And also, we have input-output ports and interfaces and cables, connecting buses. We all discuss, like you can see here, all the components of computers are connected to this. This is what we call as a processor slot. This is where the processor is kept. That's very easy to identify. It's a CPU socket. That's why multi-pin grid array. You can see small dots will be there. This is MPGA, multi-pin grid array. This is on the top of this, the processor will be placed. And very easy to identify means there will be a fan, there will be heat sinks available here. So they're easy to identify this slot, that is the socket, or this place is meant for the processor. And this is where the power is connected, power connectors, and 12-pin we are discussing about. And then we have RAM slots, so you can see here. And then it's a AGP, the black color is a graphic port. So this is an ATX motherboard. And then we have an expansion slot, we have a PCI, these are all examples. And also we have a RAM slot, so main memory. And then we have the CMOS battery. And these are all the sockets, and also you can see USB port and Ethernet ports. So these are all port. I said all the components of the computers has to be connected directly. Plugging into one of the socket or slots are connected through the ports. These are the ports through this which is connected. So this is the main circuit. That's why it's called main circuit board. And we learn all the components one by one. This is the main. Whenever you go to the market, you'll get motherboard of this like this. So on this, it's like plug and play. Everything, just you connect them. That's what I said at the end of this end of this chapter, you'll be able to configure or able to, what do you call, assemble computers by your own, depending on the requirements. So we can, what type of processor, what type of motherboard, all knowledge you'll get it, just connect them. This you have to connect one by one. All are plug and play. There is no any electronic work you have to do. Just you have to plug and play. Just insert, that becomes a part of the system and you start using it. So that is something about the motherboard. This looks like motherboard. We'll discuss about motherboard. And let us start with the components of motherboard. We'll learn one by one. The first one is we have a processor. I think everybody knows what is a processor means. The processor means the main circuit in the computers, which is responsible for performing all the operation. So it is consisting of, already I discussed about, it is a control unit, arithmetic logical unit, and also it has a registers. So temporary storage in the, so what actually this means, computer fetches data and instructions from the memory and performs the operation according to the instruction that helps, that is coordinated with the control unit, and the ALU, arithmetic logical unit, will perform those operations. All arithmetic operation, logical operations performed, and during this operations, intermediate results are generated. So these results are, has to be stored somewhere, that is done in the register. That's why it's called temporary storage. We have all the control unit responsible for control and coordinating the movement of data. So during the processing, already I said there is a movement of data between the main memory and the CPU. There are many times it does. So this is also established with the help of cables, the buses that also we are going to discuss. And one more important is when you perform operations, so intermediate results are generated, and this result has to be stored. And all the operation is done by ALU, arithmetical logical units. So that's what something about. And also the processor is identified. So how speed, or what is the speed of the processor? How do you identify the speed of the processor? Means every processor will have its own clock. The CPU defines its frequency with the processor. It executes how many data. It's like amount of data with which work at a time, or it is a number of instruction which will be executed per second. That will define the speed of the CPU. So normally the speed of the CPU will be expressed in terms of gigabytes or megabytes. How many instructions, how many data will be working at that instant. That is why it's called, normally it is expressed in terms of MIPS and BIPS, million instruction per second, billion instruction per second. And also we have so 1 gigahertz, 2 gigahertz, we have a 3 gigahertz, the processor. Even in mobiles, we have seen the processor speed. So this, the higher the speed frequency means, the more will be the instruction which the computer can execute at a time. So therefore, the execution per second normally. So as a result, what happens? The faster will be the system. That is, you buy the processor which is higher clock speed. That is the gigahertz in terms of 3 gigahertz. Definitely has the more faster or more powerful than the processor which has a 1 gigahertz. That's how. So how do you identify means? It's expressed in terms of MIPS or BIPS. So what is MIPS means? Million instructions per second. What is BIPS means? Billion instructions per seconds. So you want to identify the processor means, just you can select the right click on the properties, then you'll see the processor clock. Now we'll see about something about the processor. Already CPU is what it means, it's a main circuit. It's like already I told, the CPU is a main computer, the central processing unit is a main processor. Actually, it's a single integrated circuit which is responsible for performing all the operation which is required by the user. So that's why it's also called as a human brains. So it's a single processor, which is, we called it as a microprocessor. So that's what we can see here. So the CPU is fabricated as a single integrated circuit, and it's also known as a microprocessor. So what is a microprocessor means? It is nothing but a CPU. A CPU of computer, that's what, like human brain. So it is exactly similar. This microprocessor is nothing but our brain. How it does means all the task is done by the like classification, sorting, identifying, whatever we do in real life, our brain is responsible. Exactly similar way, this is a single processor which is responsible for, so it's not like we call this a fabricated integrated circuit. It's not only one component is there. There are many components are put together. This, when I talk about the microprocessor means, it is not only one component. There will be many components, thousands of components are put together in a small space. That is a processor, it looks like very rectangular, more than 50 pies or coins, something like that. So it's very lesser dimension, but it is a more powerful. It makes the computer CPU. That's why you call it as a tiny chip. It contains the entire computation engine. The microprocessor is plugged into the motherboard of the computers. Normally, we have to place it on the motherboard. So, Intel is one of the main manufacturer of the processors. That's why Intel processor, we have i3, i5. Along with that are AMD processor. There are different processor also. The industry is developing. But Intel is dominating in the industry where they produce the microprocessors. Now, let us look at the general structure of motherboard. So now normally what happens means the structure, the motherboard is divided into two parts. You can see here the structure of motherboard. What we have seen, that diagram, this is only like in diagram they have written. So normally motherboard is divided into two parts. One is called north bridge, other is called south bridge. So in north bridge, why we want to do this north and south bridge means, so normally what happens, there are some components inside the computers which are very fast. There are some components inside the computers which are very slow. So there is a movement of data. Definitely there is going to be movement of data. You take an example of graphic cards, or you take example of main memory and the processor. So these are high-speed devices. Normally they work with high-speed. So then what happens when you take keyboard or any serial devices and parallel devices, they are slow devices compared to this. So therefore what happens when data movement is done, so slow and speed. So we have to we have to design the architecture or the on the motherboard in such a way that data collision has to be prevented. Because whenever something is moving slow, something is moving fast means there's a possibility of colliding data. So data loss will be there. So therefore what we do means, so we keep all high-speed devices in one side That's we call as a north bridge, and we take another all slow moving devices other side, that is called as a south bridge. That's why we have a graphic card. You can see here the memory slots, a RAM, and then we have a memory controller, this one, and this is a, we can see AGP high speed graphics, and also the processor CPU, all are connected in the north bridge. As a result, what happens, so CPU is a much actually very high speed device, and the, to cope up with the CPU speed, we have a main memory RAM, which is also fast devices. So therefore they are put together, so nearby. As a result, what happens, the movement of this AGP, PCI Express speed, we have a graphic bus, all this works with a faster. So then we have, when we come back to the south bridge, you can see here, we have a IDE, that's a secondary storage devices, that's a primary memory, second, like hard disk, all are connected. Your external, that's a serial advanced technology attachment, USB, universal serial, all USB ports, Ethernet, and audio, and CMOS battery. So everything at the lower, they are slow moving. And also you can see here, serial port, parallel port, floppy disk, hard disk, keyboard, all are BIOS, all are connected at the low speed. And there is a necessity of movement, so there will be a chipset. So we call this a north bridge, this is a chipset, controller hub, this is a south bridge, controller hub. So what these two does means, they are responsible for smoothly movement of data. So there is sometimes necessity of moving data from year to year. So from this keyboard, we have to transfer data from the south bridge to the like main memory. And there is a, what is a, as a result, what happened, there may be possibility of data collisions. So this chipset, north bridge and south bridge, which monitors here, so whenever data is transferring from year to year, and this north bridge chipset will stop, block. Like it's like exactly similar to our traffic signals. So when data is moving here, it sends the signals, and making this components will not send any receiver signals, because both we are sending means there's a possibility of collision of data. As a result, data may be lost. So that is why we have two chipsets, north bridge chipset, and also we have a south bridge chipset. So their task is to control and make the movement of data, the flow of data, smooth and safe. And it's like we use signals, like red means we don't move. So where is the green means there will be movement. Exactly traffic signals, it is exactly used here, the same technique. Now you want from south bridge to north bridge means there is north bridge has to acknowledge and south bridge is willing to send. Then only the data movement takes place. So otherwise the data will be kept, but it will not take hours together or times. The traffic is not so much job, so much huge whenever we talk about this inside the computer. Even you have the more capacity, but still able to perform, because in a fraction of seconds they are working. As I told, CPU is much faster, main memory is faster. This slow means it is not slow, but still we cannot notice all these things, but inside it is happening. That's why we have a south and north bridge. This is a general structure of motherboard. So, and then we'll go with the components. You can see here all with examples. This is like, you can see here all monitors, so card device, we can see this hard disk, processor, CPU, this is a CPU, this is a DDR RAM, all are high speed devices. You can see here speakers, this BIOS, and then you have all the keyboard, mouse, connectors. This all are hard disk, secondary. These are all slow devices are connected, and these are all high speed devices are connected to this. This is a graphic card. It supports for monitors because their movement should be faster, otherwise flickering occurs and it takes much time. This is the actual north bridge and south bridge explanation. And then we'll start with the components. After the processor, we have a BIOS, basic input output system. So I think we'll continue in the next class. The remaining, like processor we have learned, the structure of motherboard we have learned, and also we discussed about different types of motherboard. I don't want you to take up too much things. Let us take, we have sufficient time, so we'll go with slowly, because these are the theory. For me, it's okay, easy to explain, but you want to learn, so therefore, let me stop here only, and then we'll take next, start from the, these are the components. So with this processor we started, then we go with the BIOS, then we'll go with each components one by one. So then CMOS, all we learn in the next class. I think you have to write the assignments and take 200 pages notebook, and at the end of this chapter, so you have a questions, 1 marks, 2 marks, 3 marks, and 5 marks. So today, whatever the questions comes under 1 marks, you write down, and also 2 marks, you write. It's like practicing. You read, watch the classes, and pause, and learn whatever doubts. If you have doubts, let me know, message me, or send to the WhatsApp group. I will explain if you want anything doubts, okay? Keep studying, don't worry. So it's all theoretical, it's not difficult. That's why I've chosen this one. Just theory, like novel, you keep reading. But you imagine something. These are all like computers. Oh, computer inside means what is there? All those with create curiosity within yourself by imagining. I think most of you know familiar with computers. But inside, when I talk about how computer components are working, all those things is very interesting if you imagine in the right way. Okay? We'll continue the next class.